I'm Miss Gregory. I am Suzanne. I'm a student nurse from USM. I'm going to go ahead and do a head-to-toe assessment. It's going to be physical exam. If you feel uncomfortable at any moment in time, go ahead and say so. Are you okay with this?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands, and you can take a seat in the chair. All right. Now we know cranial nerve 2 is intact because you made it to the chair. I'm going to go ahead and check the arm band. Okay. Can you verify your name and date of birth?
Arizona Gregory, August 15th, 1995.
All right. We also can observe skin. Hygiene looks good. Skin color is nice and even. Okay. Now, can you tell me your name again?
Arizona.
Do you know what time it is?
8:15.
Okay. And can you tell me what day it is?
Saturday.
And do you know where you're at?
Ashley's house.
Okay, now we just assess orientation times 4. We know posture is good because we're sitting up straight, and mobility is good because we made it to the chair. A nourishment looks good because we look nice and healthy. What is your height?
5'7".
Okay, and weight?
Like 100.
Okay, that's a nice healthy weight. And how are you feeling today?
Okay.
Do you have any pain?
No.
If she had any pain, we would go ahead and do alt cart and ice. To assess the pain. We know that cranial nerve 8 is intact because she answered me. We know cranial nerve 12 is intact. She enunciated her response. And we know cranial nerve 10 is intact because of the use of guttural speech sounds. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and check your vital signs. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and start with blood pressure. All right. Now I'm going to assess brachial pulse. We had a blood pressure of 112 over 66, and normal blood pressure between 110 and 139 over 60 to 79. I'm going to go ahead and do temperature. And you can go ahead and hold it. Normal temp is between 96.4 and 99.1. The average is 98.6. Temp of 97.4, and now I'm going to go ahead and auscultate the apical heart rate because it's our first time seeing you. clinical heart rate of 82, and I also did respiration. Respirations was 14, and normal heart rate is between 60 and 100, so we were normal, and respiration rate is normally between 12 and 20, so we had a normal respiration as well. All right, now we go ahead and inspect the skull, size, shape, and symmetry. All right, everything looks symmetrical visibly, and there's no lesions visible. And now I'm gonna go ahead and palpate for hair color and distribution. I'm palpating for hair texture as well as tenderness. Hair is smooth, soft. Is there any tenderness from where I'm touching? All right, the scalp also feels intact. Now I'm gonna go ahead and inspect the skin. I'm gonna palpate for, inspect for lesions anywhere else, okay. So, skin is warm and dry, soft and appropriate color, and facial features, bony structures are normal, symmetrical, and we know cranial nerve 7 is intact because we're blinking and getting a smile and frown. Okay, so we know cranial nerve 7 is also intact because we smiled and frowned. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and assess for TMJ. Can you move your jaw down and side to side? There's no clicking present. And now I'm going to go ahead and feel your frontal sinuses and your maxillary sinuses. So thank you for taking your glasses off. Tell me if there's any tenderness or pain. All right, there was no tenderness, no pain, and no swelling or anything. And I'm going to go ahead and palpate the temporal muscles. A pulse was present in the temporal, and now I'm going to go ahead and, can you clench your teeth? Thank you. Now we know cranial nerve 5 is intact because she was able to clench her teeth. And can you close your eyes lightly? I'm going to go ahead and test for sensation. Okay. First, I'm going to ask you to tell me the location. Light, dull, and sharp.
Sharp. Light. Dull. Sharp.
Okay. We have sensation. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and palpate the lymph nodes. Okay. First, we have the preauricular. Then we have the parotid. Postauricular, occipital, the sternomastoid, and the retropharyngeal, and then the submandibular, the sublingual, the submental, the anterior superficial cervical chain, and the deep cervical chain, the posterior superficial cervical chain, and I'm going to go ahead and assess the supraclavicular. Can you turn your chin? Pull your shoulder to your chin? Okay, thank you. Alright. And the other side? Thank you. Alright. And lymph nodes were nice. No swelling or tenderness was visible or palpable. Okay, and now if you could bend your head back and swallow. Okay, so we now know that nerve 9 and 10 are intact. And trachea is nice and symmetrical. It's at the midline, and there are no swelling or masses visible. Now if you can move your head forward, backwards, side to side, show the shoulders. We know cranial nerve 11 is intact. I'm gonna go ahead and ask you to push against my hands. All right, thank you. And now we know cranial nerve, we know strength is equal bilaterally. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and feel the carotid arteries. All 2 plus with no thrills or bruits. And I'm going to go ahead and observe for jugular vein distension. Alright. No masses and no jugular vein distension visible. Alright. And I'm going to go ahead and assess your vision. I know you have glasses, so vision's not great. So we got that down. Now I'm going to go ahead and inspect your eyebrows and eyelashes. They're equal, hair is evenly distributed. There's no baldness or missing hair spots. And I'm going to go ahead and look at your conjunctiva. Alright, it's nice pink color and moist. Blinking, so we already assessed the blinking. It's cranial nerve number 7 and it's working. And the sclera is white and clear, and irises are blue, and pupils are observed to be normal round. Now if you could, we're going to assess movement. Now if you could follow this. Just assessed cranial nerves 3, 4, and 6. And we have no nystagmus or and we have normal convergence. Now I'm going to go ahead and assess Perla. Alright. So I'm going to come down. That the pupils are equal, round, reactive to light, and accommodation, because the one eye accommodated to the other eye, reacting to the light. And now we also assess the reflection of both eyes by pointing this in the middle. Yep, alright, eyes are good. Okay, so now I'm going to, why am I taking it off? I'm going to look at your ears now. Okay, so the pina is, equal to the outer canthus of the eye. It's firm, feels firm, bottom is soft and flexible, and there's no discharge visible, no redness or inflammation. They feel warm, skin is normal in color. Ears are 4 to 10 centimeters in length, and okay. So now we're going to go ahead and move on to the nose. Nose is at the midline. It's symmetrical. Let me go ahead and shine this off at your nose. Okay. There's no discharge. There's no flaring. The turbinates are dark pink in color. And do you have any problems with smelling? Okay. So since we assess the smelling, since we assess smelling, we know cranial nerve 1 is intact. Do you have any problems with tasting? Can you taste salt and sweet?
Mm-hmm.
Cranial nerve 7 is intact. Can you taste sour and bitter? Cranial nerve 9 is intact. Okay, now we're going to look into your buccal mucosa, which is your mouth. But first, I'm going to assess your lips real quick. So they're pink, moist, and they have a vermilion border that separates them from the rest of the skin. Okay, now if you could open your mouth. All right. We have a pale pink with a slight vascularity. Okay, Stinson duct. Are adjacent to the upper second molar. No odor is detected. And could you flash me your teeth, please? All right, they are nice and white. They're smooth. No missing teeth. And can you look at your hard palate? Okay. And your small palate. Okay, they're hard palate, soft palate are nice. There's ridges on the hard palate and one more time. I know I keep coming back and forth, you know. Okay, so the uvula is in the midline, and the tonsils are not swollen. And I'm going to go ahead and test your gag reflex. This is the fun part, I know. Okay. Okay, gag reflex is intact. Very simple. Okay, and now if you could say ah. All right, we're good. cranial nerve 9 and 10 are intact. And if you could move your tongue to the ceiling, into 4, side to side. All right, now we have cranial nerve 12 is good. All right. Now we're going to move to the upper extremities. Okay. So color is normal, skin is warm. And now we go ahead and chest capillary refill. Okay, capillary refill was less than 3 seconds, so we're good on the capillary refill. There's no deformities present, no tenderness, correct? And now we'll go ahead and check brachial and radial pulses. Their brachial and radial pulses were symmetrical. If you put your hands back together, we have no clubbing, there's no spooning, nails are a nice 180. And now if we can go ahead and stand up, check our range of motion. All right, left side, forward, backwards, or circumduct, circular maneuver, behind the head, behind the back. All right, forward. Flex the muscles. I'm going to push and I'm going to pull and straighten out and pull. And there we go. And up, forward. All right, side to side, up, down, sway fingers and close fingers, thumbs in, thumbs out, thumbs all the way up the pinky. Good. And 1, 2, touching all the fingers. Okay, can you make a fist? And now we're going to go ahead and assess sensations again. You can take a seat again. Alright, first we're going to ask location again. Alright, your eyes closed. Alright.
Left upper arm. Right lower arm. Right hand.
Okay, now tell me if it's light, dull, or sharp. Is assessed and we're good. I'm going to go ahead and assess the heart and lungs area. Again, skin is intact, warm, scapular placement, thoracic configuration are symmetrical. We have the vertebrae is aligned, and I'm observing the pericardium and the I'm just observing the pericardium for the pulsations and the union. And no pulsations or union are present. I'm going to go ahead and palpate the point of maximum impulse, which is apical, where I've got the apical pulse. And the point of maximum impulse is present. I'm going to go ahead and auscultate for breath sounds. First, I'm going to listen for vesicular sounds, which are of normal peripheral lung fields over most of both the lungs, and then bronchiovascular sounds, which are normal over the first and second intercostal space and the sternal border, and then the posterior at the T4 medial scapula. And the bronchial sounds can be heard over the manubrium. right now I'm going to go ahead and auscultate the heart rate and rhythm. I'm going to look at the aortic area and the pulmonic area, the herbs point, the tricuspid area, and the mitral area. Is present, S1 is louder at the apex and S2 is louder at the base. Heart rate was regular and rhythm was nice. Okay. Have you had any changes in urination or bowel movement?
No.
Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and ask you to lay on the floor so I can assess your bowel sounds in the abdomen. Okay. So, first I'm going to inspect and I see skin is smooth, no lesions, no masses visible. Okay, and I'm gonna go ahead and auscultate first. I'm gonna start in the right upper quadrant. Left upper quadrant.
It's so weird, it looks opposite.
Left lower quadrant. Right lower quadrant. Alrighty, and now I'm going to go ahead and palpate lightly. Tell me if anything is painful or tender in it. Okay. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and palpate deeply. Bend forward so I can assess your spine. Alright, spine is nice alignment. Now you can bend backwards. Alright, and move side to side. And do like a twisting circular movement. Okay, so now we assess range of motion. Now can you bend a shallow squat? There we go. Alright, and could you walk the assess gait? Gait is nice and normal. Now can you heel toe? Alright, gait is normal. Now stand with your arms to the side, eyes closed, and new visible swing. And now pick up one leg. Alright, now pick up the other. Alright, good posture. Falling to the side. Alright, you can go ahead and sit down again. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and assess your legs. Skin is nice, warm, no shaved legs, so there's no hair distribution to observe. I'm going to go ahead and ask you to pull back to your hands and go ahead and pull forward. Alright, I'm going to check capillary refill. Capillary refill was less than 3 seconds, so we're good on capillary refill. And now I'm going to go ahead and check the pulses in your legs. So I'm going to start the dorsal pedis. Yes. Were present in the legs, and now I'm going to go ahead and test for your cerebral function, if you could wrap it. Alright, and now heel to shin on both legs, please, and thank you. Alright, and thank you, Ms. Gregory, for your time today. Range of motion was great. You had a perfect exam today, and I look forward to seeing you again one day. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Ooh, 25 minutes.